Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the main event of the evening. A super welterweight bout in our fourth 3-minute round. Would you please welcome, from Stockport, Dale, the choir boy,
going to struggle to see Fraser because he's got his crowds here. Quick fact, just before Gregory Houston comes down, both Fraser and Gregory attended the same primary school, I believe. I won't switch cars if there's a guy in my way. You're still going to struggle to see anything in here. Well, Fraser, I've seen him fight as an amateur. And I'm looking forward to seeing him as a pro. It's his pro debut. It's the main event of the evening. I'm just going to ask this guy moving my way one second. This song is a favourite up north, as you can tell. It's a favourite in every boxing venue, but up north, even I'm pretty sure up in there last year, one of the judges sang it to the crowd. But this will be an amazing main event. As I say, Gregory will come down in a wee second.
This is the main event of the evening, Sam Kynoch from Kynoch Boxing Promotions. Brings to a super welterweight contest in the fourth 3-minute round. Our officials are appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control. Sure, the challenge is Mr. Denny Trainor.
So that was the boss getting in the way.
And at the bell
rings, as I said, there's a busy event.
Introducing first in the red corner, red black shorts with silver, weighing 11 stone 2 pounds. Tonight, he reaches the half century, competing in his landmark 50th professional contest from Stockport, Dale. Silver shorts with blue and white. He made it at 11 stone 1 pound tonight. Making his professional debut!
As I said, Gregory Houston in the ring announcer, just leaving the ring, we'll be heading down here. Referee just giving his final instructions to both boxers. So I'm now joined in commentary. The great Gregory Houston. How are you doing, Greg?
All right, cheers, aye. Nice to be getting towards the end of the night anyway.
So, final night, final. You've seen, you must have seen Fraser before as well. In fact, I just said you went to the same school.
Yeah, years apart,
but yeah, we're both from Hopeman, to give it its proper name, but as the locals call it, Houtman. Yeah, so we went to Houtman Primary School. I didn't really know him living up there, but I've seen him quite a bit in the amateurs. He's a very capable amateur. And he's a good start here.
And the thing is, he's grown, he's more, I know he's moved up in weight, as a lot of young boxers have done during COVID. I didn't see someone for 17 months, you see them, they're completely different people. But he's fighting a very experienced, you just said, his opponent is in his 50th professional boxing fight. We've seen earlier with Ryan Gall versus Gary McGuire, these gentlemen don't always give an easy fight. But Fraser has very much control.
Yeah, he's using that southpaw jab very well. He's finding the openings with it. You know, and he's coming through with the left when the chance is there. I mean, Arrowsmith's got the gloves up. He's taking a lot on there, but Fraser is still landing a good number.
He has got the crowd behind him. It's always a rowdy crowd up north.
Yeah, especially when they're making a long trip like this. It's... Elgin's only ever... He boxed out of the Elgin Club, and they've only ever had one or two guys turn pro. There was Lee McBride back in the late 90s, early 2000s. And then we've got Andrew Smart, is professional now with McAllister up at Northern Sporting Club. Yeah, so they don't often get this kind of excuse to go to these kind of nights. So it's a big thing for them.
I know you're this year, but last year I was at the Nairn Home Show. It's in December this year. You're going to be there ring announcing. It's a very, very lively crowd. The venue just makes it even more like amazing. It's like an amphitheatre.
Yeah, that is a rowdy crowd at Nairn. I'm going to be in Elgin in November as well, and the crowd they get there are fantastic as well. That's always a good show.
I'll maybe try and see you there. I'll maybe try and get up there. So I'm talking about Nairn. To me, it's just up north.
Yeah.
back to the fight, Fraser, he's in fantastic form. Do you think COVID played a part in him turning pro? Do you think he would have wanted to stick to amateur for a bit longer?
I think it probably did. He would have likely wanted to get in through a few more championships. But as with, I think, quite a few boys and girls, there's been that long a break that you're then suddenly playing catch-up a bit. But, you know, trying to get the medals, and what age are you going to be by the time you've done all that and going pro? I mean, I still feel some of them could wait a bit longer. A lot of guys and girls go pro in the early 20s. I think we're in a game where boxers last longer, and it's not a disaster to wait till you're in your mid-20s to turn pro. But some of them do turn pro in the late teens, early 20s, and they have a good career. So, you know, they know what's best for them, and their coaches know what's best for them.
But it's great. Fraser's in fantastic form. He looks the part. Has been... I know he's had an amateur career, and I was speaking this with Jay earlier. We don't know if John Carpenter in the last fight had... Do you know anything about his background, if he'd an amateur? Or?
I don't know. This was the first I'd ever really heard of him.
He looked very comfortable early on. Yeah. He got a bit frustrated that his opponent wasn't he? Sort of the same shots well. But we're in second round.
Yeah, again, setting up with a jab, just coming through the left nicely. He's not rushing in either. That you see a lot of guys on their debut will rush in and waste so many punches. Yeah,
especially in a four-rounder with a crowd like this. He's keeping his composure. He's been taunted a bit, I think, by Adam Smith.
Dale's one of those journeymen who always enjoys being in the ring, so you're going to get... But that's good. That's good as well, to have an opponent who'll behave like that.
To be honest, Gary McGuire done it earlier with Ryan. Like, he was sort of waving his right fist about and stuff.
Yeah.
But they're not here to make it easy. And I think with Ryan Gall's last fight, you can find out that journeyman will sometimes, if you're not ready, if you're not bringing your A game, they'll expose that. And I think Ryan is bounced back. So Fraser needs to still keep an eye on his opponent, which I think he is doing. He's not rushed in. He's being composed.
Yeah. He's got a good team behind him. He's got Sam Mullen from Doon Valley in the corner tonight. But his main coach back up home, Paul Gordon Ratch, is a great coach. He's the only reason he's not in the corner is he's not had his interview yet for his licence. He's got that on Sunday. So he'll be working the corner going forward. But Ratchett's a very good coach. He's brought through a lot of good boxers at Elgin. His own daughter was at the Commonwealth Games. Megan Gordon, great boxer as well. So yeah, he's got a good team.
I really appreciate this experience that you're bringing to this. You travel the country more than me. You know, like, boxers, you obviously have to announce them, and you've seen them from a young age, you've seen them grow and then come to professional level, which is good. And to throw that in there, that you both went to the same school, both for the same area.
Yeah.
You announced his first fight. No doubt this will be his first fight, first win. Maybe further in his career, you can announce future.
And the thing is, there is obviously a bit of emotional investment for me seeing a guy from back home doing so well, doing this. And if it does come to bigger fights, that is going to be the challenge of keeping it professional, I'll tell you that.
That's what I get dragged into all the time, is chatting and all be biased and stuff like that when we do the podcast. But Fraser I love watching him fight when he fought Alan Mahmood. I also like Alan Mahmood for Dundee. And it is good to see, because he is a nice guy, and you find young guys from these areas up north, a bit like yourself, they're very well spoken, very articulate in the ring and outside the ring. And I think we're seeing this now. I think end of round two. Just another shout out, the Ring Girls, Diamond Dolls, the after party as usual, but you guys won't get to be there because this will be on tomorrow night. But feel free to head down to Diamond Dolls any day of the week.
Yeah, they were trying to get me to head up there tonight, but
I heard that. I was like, they were introduced to you, saying, "Oh, these are your." I think they said, "These are your girls." I was like, "Excuse me."
No,
but they made it clear. You're a new daddy. Congratulations on that. Cheers. How are you finding that?
Different, but yeah, it's good. She's a lovely wee girl. Four and a half months now, and yeah, it's amazing. Yeah.
Congratulations.
She'll, once she's old enough, she'll probably be at a good few boxing events.
I was going to say that because it's quite a lot of family business for you. Your dad helps out, your missus helps out as well at times.
Yeah, we won't be seeing my wife at many shows in the next few years. I don't
your
think.
Daughter will be taking her place. Yeah.
But yeah, I've got Casey to get home to, and I've also got to be up early tomorrow anyway. It's the Scottish schoolboy and junior, yep. School age and junior championships over the weekend. So
it's good just to see boxing back in all levels. And you see someone like Fraser that's came through the amateurs that has now got a big crowd behind him, who've travelled miles. And it's good to see his debut, his main event in this show. I put that to the tickets that he sold and the people that have came and supported him, but they obviously believe in him. You've seen him fight, I've seen him fight. Like, he's going to be an amazing professional boxer. He'll no doubt bring many, many good fights in the future.
Yeah, it's very, very good footwork there as well, keeping up on the toes. Keeping the hands are a bit low there.
That's one thing
I hate with some guys on their debuts.
He has got good headwork though. He has dodged a few there.
Yeah.
But this all comes with experience.
Yeah.
The professional fights are very much different for the amateur. There's a lot more, there's no showboat, it's a lot more sort of gentleman-like. The rounds are less. I know this is four rounders, but soon he'll be no doubt hitting 6, 8, 10.
Yeah,
he has paced himself. Like, there's also four rounds. Like, the other fights tonight seem to go quite quick.
Yeah, that first one, I don't know how they kept that pace up for four rounds.
They
just wanted to batter each other.
I said I could watch that all night.
Yeah, I don't think they could keep going all night.
Arrowsmith is taunting him, which...
Dale's just a very happy guy. He's always smiling.
I mean, these gentlemen, they don't make it easy for young boxers that, if, as I said, you need to bring your A game. Don't think you're in for an easy fight. They will be looking to expose your weaknesses if you're not. Look at this.
Yeah, and it's not even that exposing weakness isn't them necessarily looking to don't care that, but if they see that you're keeping the hand low, they will throw the punch to teach you. Yeah. That's you know, an opening you've left. Stop leaving it open.
And to be honest, I've seen that with Ryan Gall, like a few left hooks with Gary Maguire to the right side of his head. As he's going to hurt in the morning, he's going to have to learn. But again, in the four rounders, they do try and commit all guns blazing and sort of push themselves. So you get the Boxing Scotland shows at the weekend.
Yep. I think I've seen the running order. I think it's about 30 odd bouts one day and about 20 odd the other. Two rings.
Yeah, once we tried to film them all, and it was like, I think we left with 50 fights each day. And then, when about that, we had home shows, or there was some, or maybe a professional show, and it was just, I literally just locked myself in to edit. Because people, literally, the minute you finish filming the fight, they start messaging you, where's the fight?
Yeah.
And they don't get that there's. Here we go. Final round. Crowds on their feet.
Yeah. Just keep it the same, just keep it nice and easy, work in the jab, keep moving around, protect yourself, and you've got it in the bag. Good overhand right there from Fraser.
Let's get aggressive in this round, but
yeah.
I just got a flashback to a word that the wrestling commentators just use, a slobber knocker.
Yeah.
I just done it, a slobber knocker. Which is good, because I like to see boxers test. I need to watch.
A wee damn happy there. We're getting a bit scrappy here with the holding and tussling around. That was a nice uppercut there. Couple of rights to the body, but taken on the arms.
Arrowsmith is saying to him, come on, but Fraser has given up. As I said, he has got decent head movement.
Yeah, I think.
But he is getting caught up. He's getting caught up in.
I think it's the last round of a debut is always a funny one. Because it's not. You can find yourself tired, I think. And it's not a fitness thing. You only have that debut once. Yeah. It's the start of your career. There's a whole different thing with the adrenaline and the emotional aspect of it, and I think as you hit that final round knowing you're about to get that first win, it can, you know, put you in a funny place. And you see a lot of guys in that final round of the debut can sort of look like they're tiring, but as I say, it's not a fitness thing, it is the occasion. So that's one thing, Fraser is super fit.
Yeah, I was saying this, like, the difference in him, this is getting really scrappy. Yeah. The difference in him from when I seen him before, it's a completely different, he's very much more athletic, his build is as well, he looks taller as well. I just caught him in the back there before he came out, just to sort of wish him good luck, but I think he's a bit height of me. And I've seen that with some amateur boxers, I hadn't seen him in 17 months, and they're you get Finn and Renfrewshire boxing is calling him, you know. Hey, this is our blind spot. That's it.
Right, I'll bid you farewell.
Here we go, Gregory, thanks so much. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Jamie.
That's Gregory Hoosen, everybody. He's going to jump back to the ring, get the judges' scorecard. The fans, we've got quite a look at the fans who, they look like they've already announced a winner. Fraser smiling in the ring, his corner looks happy. I think he's done his, now going over his thanking his opponent, who didn't give him an easy chance. He's thanking the audience, which he also done in amateurs. He always was respectful of the people that come out to support him. And this has been an amazing debut. And I think Arrowsmith did not make it easy for him, was trying to wind him up at times. And here we go as we go to the... We'll go over back to Gregory Houston.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, please let's hear it for both boxers. After four rounds, the referee scores the contest 14-36. In favor of the winner, Fraser Wilkinson!
As expected, Fraser has pulled off in tremendous fashion. As I said, very athletic. The last time I seen him was an amateur. He wasn't as big, but he's got bigger. He always had athleticism, always able to conduct himself very, very nicely in the ring. But now we've seen him, his fans are going absolutely crazy. I'm going to try and grab him before he leaves. So just give me a wee second.
426-430. Do you have that information?
Hey, Fraser, I've got to bring you in close because it is crazy in here. You've got all your fans doing Felgen. Amazing debut. We expected that. We've seen you fighting an amateur. Are you happy?
That beats any moment in my career so far. You know what I mean? That's what you dream of as a child and all the next one, doing.
So, I was speaking, like, you've grown, you're more athletic, you've put on muscle, and you've got taller because you're about the same height as me now. How was the difference between amateur and professional? What made you make the decision to turn pro?
Basically, I'm a pro now. I'm not in the amateur, you know what I mean?
And I think you proved that. Gregory Houston was on commentary with me, and we said Arrowsmith was kind of trying to wind you up and push you. These other gentlemen, they were all trying to expose the weaknesses, but I think you kept your composure.
Yeah.
You kept control of that fight, and it's amazing. You're top of the bill as well in your first debut because of all these fans. But what can we expect next?
Big things. Just going to keep climbing the ladder, get my respect, and any real title might come my way, whatever level it's at, you know.
Yeah. Listen, Fraser, I know we'll get people waiting. The guys behind are going absolutely nuts. Well done, my man, and I'll see you shortly. Yeah?
Well done.